a fact. If you watch the sky at night.
Greetings, everybody. Welcome to Season 2, Episode 10 of Rock the Word 153. I'm Father John Zagarella, Norbertine at Dalesford Abbey, and here we are in a bit of a different setting today. We are in the Springhouse. You know, Rock the Word 153 is a feature on our Springhouse media, and the Springhouse is actually the chapel of John the Baptist. We're filming this on Thursday, June 24th, which is the Solemnity of St. John the Baptist. And this is actually the season finale of Rock the Word 153 for Season 2. And we thought it would really, really be special if we filmed this last episode of Season 2 in and around the Chapel of the Baptist. So you'll notice that for this episode, the scenery might change a little bit. It is a special episode indeed on this Solemnity of St. John the Baptist. And it's a very special episode because it features a song that I really love by Elton John called Answer in the Sky on his 2004 album, Peachtree Road. So I'd like to give a little bit of a shout out to Bernie Taupin, who is responsible for these great lyrics that we hear. And the reason why I chose this for the season finale, you'll know that this is my third Elton John song that I'm featuring in Rock the Word, two in the first season and the season finale here in season two. And the thought has always crossed my mind because there's so many songs that Bernie Taupin wrote and that Elton John performed that for me are great inspirations and would be perfect material for Rock the Word 153. So today we're gonna feature another one. But one of the thoughts that I had along the way was maybe to do a special episode of Rock the Word where we combine a few of those songs. So for today, it's Answer in the Sky by Elton John on his 2004 album, Peachtree Road. So in this great song, written by Bernie Taupin and sung by Elton John, the lyrics are especially spiritual, I think, and especially bring to mind some really terrific scriptures that I'd like to share with you today. So the song starts out like this. Well, they say that it's a fact. If you watch the sky at night, and if you stare into the darkness, you might see celestial light. And if your heart is empty and there's no hope inside, there's a chance you'll find an answer in the sky. Well, they say that it's a shame if you have nothing to believe. And if you can hold on to something, you might as well die where you sleep. You know, brothers and sisters, I've often wondered, how do people without faith make it through the challenges and difficulties of life? And that is reflected in this song. If your heart is empty and there's no hope inside, you'll find an answer, but it's a shame if you have nothing to believe. And it really, really is. So I think the words really nail down a reality of our faith, that our faith, without our faith, how would we ever get through the challenges and difficulties of daily life? So, so Elton continues, and it's all so much bigger than it seems, and it all overwhelms us now and then. And I'm banking on a chance that we believe that good can still control the hearts of men. And I love that sentiment too, because it's about faith, not only in God, but faith in one another, faith in human beings. That he says that life is a long, long road. This is my favorite part of the song. He said, this life's a long, long road, but we shouldn't have to walk alone. And if you find the right companion, you won't feel so worn out when you've grown. All life is precious and every day is a prize. And sometimes you'll find an answer in the sky, right? So the long journey of life, but every day is precious and all life is precious. So here we are in these beautiful surroundings. All of life is precious. Our lives are precious. The lives of the trees and the plants and the animals. I don't know if you could hear it, but we could hear the frogs croaking in the background. All of life is precious. Right? So that got me to thinking. One of the first things that I thought of was the journey of Abram and Sarah, right? So from Genesis 12, 1 to 9, the Lord said to Abram, go forth from your land, your relatives, and your father's house to a land that I will show you. I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you. So Abram went as the Lord had directed him with Lot. Abram was 75 years old when he accepted the command of the Lord to move on, right? This life's a long, long road, but we shouldn't have to go alone. So here's Abram going with Lot and Sarah. And they took everything that they had, and they set out for the land of Canaan. From there, Abram moved to the hill country east of Bethel, and then the Lord invoked Abram by name, and then Abram journeys on by stages to the Negev, and then on to Egypt. So at 75 years old, Abram takes Sarai and Lot, and off they go. And we know that Abram and Sarai, their names, because of their covenant with God and because they were tested in their faith and they passed the test, their names are changed, you know. So Abram becomes Abraham and Sarai becomes Sarah. So they journey with the Lord. They journey together. You know, they find the right companion in one another. They journey. They find the Lord. The Lord saves them. He makes good on his promises to them. And it's a beautiful relationship between Abraham, Sarah, and the Lord. And that sense that, you know, if all we have to do is look up. One of the things I love about Daylesford Abbey is when it gets really dark out and you walk down the road and you look up at the sky and you can see the stars. Stars are so beautiful here at night. But what Elton sings in this song is that if you stare into the darkness, you might see a celestial light. That sense of that we need to somehow be strong enough to stare into the darkness so that the light of Christ can conquer it. So if you stare into the darkness, you might see a celestial light. God is everywhere, brothers and sisters. He's even in those places where we think he might not be. God is always with you. And that made me think of a passage from Isaiah 43, 1 to 5. But now, thus says the Lord, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through waters, I will be with you. Through rivers, you shall not be swept away. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, nor will flames consume you. For I, the Lord, am your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. Because you are precious in my eyes and honored, I love you. Fear not, for I am with you. All life is precious, Elton says, and every day is a prize. The Lord calls us precious in that reading from Isaiah. And so, in the New Testament, we hear that in a different way from Matthew 28, 19 to 20. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am with you always until the end of the age. Through the Old Testament and through the New Testament, the Lord God and the Lord Jesus make that promise to me and you that they will always, always, always be with us. How can people make it through life without faith in God? How can people make it through life without faith in God? We always have our Lord God with us, even in those places where we think he's not there. We peer into the darkness and we might see the celestial light of his face. So, at one point in this song, where he talks about, you know, again, I quoted this in the beginning, but I'll quote it again. Well, they say that it's a shame if you have nothing to believe, and if you can't hold on to something, you might as well die where you sleep. You don't need a prayer, and there's no price to ask why. So sometimes, you know, when we're feeling like our heart is empty, we feel like we can't pray, or we feel like if we pray, God isn't listening. But in fact, God is listening. And God, Lord Jesus, taught us how to pray. And I thought it would be nice to conclude this episode, the last episode of season two, with two excerpts from the New Testament where Jesus talks not only about prayer, but about our role and what it means to pray. So here we find in Matthew 6, 9 to 15, where Jesus teaches his disciples to pray. And of course, it's the very familiar Our Father. This is how you are to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And do not subject us to the final test, but deliver us from the evil one. And here, this is so powerful, because it follows right after the Our Father. If you forgive others their transgressions, your heavenly Father will forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your transgressions. So, yes, we do need a prayer. We do need to pray, but we also have to live our lives as if we are praying. We have to live by our actions into the prayers that we say, into the prayers that we pray. Luke chapter 6, 27 to 38 puts it another way. But to you who hear, I say, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who mistreat you. To the person who strikes you on one cheek, offer the other one as well. And from the person who takes your cloak, do not withhold even your tunic. Do unto others as you would have them do to you. Stop judging, and you will not be judged. Stop condemning, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. For the measure with which you measure will in return be measured out to you. So, brothers and sisters, as we look to the sky to talk to God, as we look for our answer in the sky, the Lord does teach us how to pray. But our part is that we have to live into that prayer. Yes, all we have to do is open our arms and our hearts to God, look up to the Lord, look up to the sky, look up and find the answer that Jesus is with us and he hears our prayers. So we do need to pray. We do need to journey. And on our journey, we find the right companions, but the Lord is always right beside us. So no matter what the journey of our lives looks like, let's always be faithful to our prayer. Let's always look to our Heavenly Father in the beauty of nature as we look up to the sky. And even as we look into our darkness, remember, we might see our celestial life. All life is precious, and every day is a prize. And sometimes you'll find that answer in the sky. Brothers and sisters, I hope you enjoyed Rock the Word 153 from our Chapel of the Baptist, and keep on praying. Keep on looking up at the beauty of the sky. And sometimes, you know what? You're going to find that answer in the sky. We'll see you in the middle of August, and maybe we'll have a little surprise podcast sometime in July. But we'll be back with season three of Rock the Word 153 around the 13th of August. See you then. Take care. Have a great summer. Keep praying. All life is precious, you know, and every day is a prize. God love you.
The darkness, you might see celestial light. And if your heart is empty and there's no hope inside, there's a chance you'll find an answer in the sky. A shame if you have nothing to believe, and if you
got us. Well, die where you sleep. You don't need a prayer, and there's no price to ask why. Sometimes you'll find an answer in the sky. And it's all so much bigger than it seems, and it all overwhelms us now and then. And I'm banking on a chance that we believe the good can still control the hearts of men. Feel so worn out when you've grown. Oh, life is pretty.